And also, too, just before we let you go, Professor, I understand you, you've evaluated charter schools both in the United States and abroad. Can you talk about it and how who's doing a better job in that realm?
Yeah, what I've internationally, what I've looked at is the national voucher reform in Sweden back in the 90s, and I've looked at school restructuring in four countries in Europe. Here in the States, I've done a lot both for the federal government, looking at the correlates of success in American charter schools, and then I've been called upon by state education agencies to do evaluations of nine different state evaluations of charter schools. And I've done a lot of technical assistance for charter schools as well, helping them to demonstrate success according to the idea of charter schools, which is that they're going to be mission driven. So that's some of the experience that I have. And what I'm seeing here in the States is a few of the states I've worked with, like Connecticut and Delaware, are performing relatively well compared to other states like my home state of Michigan or Ohio, where we see the performance of charter schools lacking, oversight lacking, and some of the other.
Well, in fairness, Connecticut has hardly any charter schools and Michigan has a whole bunch, right?
That's a common thread I often see. And it depends a lot on the, I think, when the charter school law is being formulated, when there's greater bipartisan support, they tend to have smaller reforms, more restrictive in the numbers, but the focus is more on the quality of the schools rather than the quantity. I think in states like Ohio and Michigan, I think there's a desire that to get as many schools up and running to put the competitive pressure on the traditional public schools, but there's less focus on the quality aspect.
I guess I would just say, I would ask you though, isn't it true there could be a case where, let's say there's a grade F district school, and in some of these other states, maybe there are some grade C or D charter schools, and they have a lot of charter schools, but they have many that are grade C or D, but they're still better than the grade F district school. And a guy like you comes along and says, oh, look, your average charter school performance is weaker than a place like Connecticut, where they're all A and B, and they have way fewer. But to the parents on the ground, they'd rather have a C minus option instead of the F-rated district school they're in Ohio or Michigan. So what about that idea?
Well, parents choose for a lot of reasons, not only the quality or the student performance data. They choose for often for other reasons. But when I look at schools, I don't look at and do those simplistic comparisons. We usually try to do more sophisticated matching of students and schools so they can be compared to relative comparison groups in the traditional public school sector.
I know. I guess the question is, if you're an authorizer, though, I know I'm simplifying here, but it's a principle I'm explaining that can be summarized this way, is that if, you know, would you shut down a C-grade charter school if the kids end up going to an F-grade district instead? I don't think I would.
Right. And that's one of the issues. We're also seeing some charter schools saying, we may be failing, but so are the traditional public schools, and why aren't you closing them? And I got an answer to that. Well, and the answer is that there was a deal about charter schools. We didn't want to replicate traditional public schools. We wanted something better.
Well, if they're as bad, then maybe you're right. I would just say if they're a little better, then that's the argument I'm making. But at any rate, I take your point on that. We want to thank Professor Gary Mirin from the Western Michigan University and also the National Education Policy Center for joining us on Reform School. You've been a great guest. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Bob.
All right. And
enjoy the day.
All right. And for Chris and Heather and Allison and Alex and Kate, that's nice to have. I like how he does his shots around. And also the... I've been enjoying the Tonight Show theme song too. Do you remember Heather the Tonight Show theme song at all? Did you ever watch Johnny Carson? Do you know who that is?
I know who it is, but I've never watched it.
Would you be able to identify him like on a lineup? You know, like of photos of faces. Would you be able to identify?
Maybe.
All right. We have now a game show element for the next program. We'll see you next time, everybody.